This is K. Lakshmi Narayan.
Hello, who?
Associate Professor in Department of Economics. I was also president at that time when this incident took place. President of the University of Hyderabad Teachers Association. So that is how I am connected to this incident.
Now you are not?
Now.
You resigned?
You have resigned?
Not resigned. My term is over.
When? Can you give me a date? When?
I was there up to November. In December we had elections and some other field has come. So, we were, after the professorial board, I had just hearing the incident where I was involved. Some sequence of events. When the proctorial board has been formed, they also included the representatives of the teachers association.
And in writing or?
They invited, they did not inform us. It was a very emergency meeting. They did not inform us. We are invited as special invitees, having no board members. But that they did it only after the meeting was over. So, after we went to that meeting, proctorial board meeting, what happened was, before actual meeting took place, there was another meeting that was already going on by the proctorial board chairperson and other members, and we were asked to sit in another room for some time. So there itself, I sensed that something wrong was going on, because how come a section of the committee will meet before the entire...
Can you give a date?
This is on 10th August.
Sorry, this proctorial board has any SST representations of the teachers belonging to SST?
I think there was one. I did not remember that day whether he has come or not.
No, but it was a formal representation or by virtue of?
I think it was a formal also. As a teacher's association.
Not an SCST board.
No, proctorial board. Representation there.
Yes, there was.
Formally.
As a teacher.
Not a SCST representative. They just selected one person from the community and he represented.
Not as a teacher, ex officio chairperson. You were the president of the teachers association.
Yes, UHTA president.
But you were invited in the proctorial board as a SCST member.
No. That is different.
Okay. And if you don't mind, do you belong to a SCST?
Yes. So then there was some other meeting which they were having, and after that meeting, and we were there, we took notes and we have followed the positions. And at the end of the meeting, they said that you have no voting rights and you can't participate in decision meeting. So then we said that is it the order of the registrar that they showed that is the order, and you will not be involved in decision making that we are going to do, so please go. And then this one point I want to mention here, that during the depositions we came to know that the Sushil Kumar, who was he is a ABP person, and during the deposition we came to understand that when some people went to his room, it's not 30 people actually, it's only 3-4 people who went to his room and asked him to come down, and before the hostel they were standing, and before the hostel there may be some 30 students, but to his room only 4-5 people went. And in that discussion, we came to understand that he has a direct connection with the Gachibowli police station. So he was, when they were asking for apology, and he was calling police, and apart from the security which has been ordered by the DSW, already there, they were already there, but because of his call, or maybe university also, whether it knows or not, I don't know, two policemen already arrived. And after 5 minutes, and a police patrol van also arrived. This point I am mentioning, that how there is a connection or a collaboration between the ABUP president and the police station, Gachibowli police station, and it also came out that he has, I don't know exactly, but this WhatsApp thing, this SI is there. So every second or every minute, he is able to interact with those persons. Now the other thing is, when we are told that we are not allowed to participate in decision making, we wrote that as a protest we submitted our own report, and we clarified that whatever this Proctorial Board Committee will decide, we have nothing to do with it. Because we have our own views, and our views are not allowed to be taken into account. Now, when we submitted this report, and we also protested that this is not the way to constitute a committee. And decision has to be taken by involving all the members, and it has to be more or less some kind of uniform opinion or whatever. So this we indicated to Vice Chancellor also.
And that time what, Sharma was?
Yes, R.P. Sharma.
Was he a doctor?
He was in charge.
In charge.
So
he also. Did he reply sent you a letter?
He didn't reply, but we told him that whenever you appoint committees in future, don't do this way. We also asked the Proctorial Board chairperson that why you have included. He said that since you have some popularity among the students, that is the reason. That is how they are trying to utilize for the things which they are doing. And in this report, actually we have mentioned 2-3 points. One is that there is no evidence of physical violence on any of the student in our own report, which we submitted to the Vice Chancellor. And also, university abdicated its responsibility in allowing police into the campus. Especially when this heavy student called, they came. And the third thing we said, that the police also showed high-handedness by taking some of the students on the same day to the police station. These things we have mentioned, and we said it is a strong dissent, but this was ignored.
Can we get that report? This report is not in the document.
Which one?
The report that you
page 48.
Yes. Yes. This is a letter to the Vice Chancellor.
Right.
You see.
So, this is our feeling that this would have served as a document to avoid the subsequent events if they are very serious and sincere. And ultimately which led to the death of the victim. About the Proctorial Board, actually it has, after we were not there, then they submitted two reports. The first report is on 12th August. 10th August we had a meeting, and 12th August they submitted a... 10th we had, 12th. So, in that report also, they said there is no hard evidence of beating of ABUP students, Mr. Sushil Kumar. That is the first report. And of course, as said earlier, that they gave some warning, although they gave some very very stupid suggestion that there should not be any organizations in the universities. But with this warning, it is first report is over. And second report which they submitted on 31st August. Of course, they did not call first report as interim report. Later they were trying to tell this is an interim report like that. But nowhere it is mentioned that it is an interim report. Second report they submitted on 31st August, and then they said there is an evidence of beating. Actually, there is no additional information or evidence of feeling except one, that is one-sided version of Sushil Kumar, who did not attend in the first meeting. That is the only additional information they have, but they came to this conclusion. I want to just mention that between these reports of this proctorial board and the punishment date, the punishment given to the universities, I feel there are some things have happened in a sequential manner. One is that one BJP Rangareddy district in charge, Mr. Nandanam Divakar, he wrote a letter to the Dattatreya on 10th August itself, where this proctorial board meeting was held. Same day, he wrote a letter, Rangareddy district BJP president or vice president, to the Bandari Dattatreya. And Dattatreya wrote a letter to MHRD on 17th August. Yes. So just the dates I am mentioning, between these two reports and implementation order, some of these things have happened. And the ministry wrote back a letter to university on 3rd September. And university suspended Dalit students on 8th September. So between these, these things have happened. So this indicates that AVP and administration, and then connection with BJP letter to Dattatreya, Dattatreya letter to MHRD, MHRD letter to university, and university punishment of Dalit student. So there is something that connection. The other thing I want to mention is that because of serious objections from...
I'm sorry to interrupt.
Yeah.
MHRD letter is actually signed by whom? What is the name and designation?
Yes, sir. All these letters are here. Signed by whom?
Signed by...
There are several people who have signed. There was a deputy undersecretary, Ramji Pandey. There was an email on 3rd September from Ramji Pandey. Then there was a letter from the deputy secretary MHRD on 24/9. And then there was another letter from the deputy secretary on 6th October. All these letters are included in this. And then again a letter from the joint secretary MHRD on 20th October.
So, because of serious objections from students and teachers, university administration revoked that suspension which they gave on 8th September and ordered for a fresh inquiry. That is the decision during the R.P. Sharma, this has happened. And the MHRD is very surprising to say
in
that...
the revocation of suspension, there is no mention about fresh inquiry.
Yes,
there is.
Well mentioned. So, the other point is that between 3rd September and 19th November, within 2.5 months, MHRD wrote five letters. Almost every fortnight one letter. How this is indicate their so-called seriousness, how to punish...
very active government.
Very active against Dalits and Dalit students to give punishment. So active, I don't think they have been active in any other instances. Also here I want to add, they also could get an order from High Court. This entire machinery, BJP and other, they got an order from the High Court saying that it is under what you have done. Because after suspension, they were thinking that was revoked by the students and the teachers. So they were worried they were not punished. So how to punish them, they went. And I also personally came to know that a lawyer close to RSS, he got an order asking the university what you have done. So these five letters from the ministry and the court order, in a way, asking the university to explain action taken on the Dalit student. Then Professor Appa Rao appeared on the scene and he came and he constituted a committee, EC subcommittee, and it met on 23rd and 24th November, by that time, just one point, that it was not a fresh inquiry. It was ordered by the university itself, he violated that. That inquiry is only, they asked to observe or examine the recommendations of the, that earlier, that proctorial board which has faulty recommendations or faulty report, etc. That was the only mandate, it was not a fresh inquiry of the entire incident. That would have exposed them, that is one of the reasons of taking points. The other is, they also neglected, I think, police commissioner's letter, where he said there was not much, it was a very small incident. And they did not put this report, commissioner's report, in this committee, in this meeting, EC committee meeting. And EC committee, surprisingly, it wrote, we concurred with the entire report and recommendations like that. And after that, I am told that it is not, this EC subcommittee did not give specific recommendation, just said concurred the reports. But EC, when EC met, and Professor Abarao being the chairperson of that, and actually they proposed this social boycott in that executive council meeting. So the, in this way, actually there is a complete collaboration between ABAP, University Administration, Police, BJP, Ministry of HRD and even. I think that is how this caste discrimination became so powerful and which has taken the life.
I think EC Abarao, Professor Abarao, what caste he belongs to?
Kamma caste. You know, Kamma in Kostlandra.
Chandrababu Naidu's caste.
Yes, landed. It's a landed gentry. And maybe one or two sentences that the clashes between the agricultural laborers and landlords in Kostlandra appears in the form of Kamma versus Dalits. That is what happened in Karamchedu incident and even Chuturu. So that way there was a strong feelings of, I don't say all, but caste society, most of the Kammas will have against that is also this kind of vengeance.
And the registrar, what's his name?
His name right now Sudhakar.
What caste?
He also belongs to Kamma. I should also mention one more thing. There is a security officer, deputy registrar. Actually, he was picked out from military. He came from Navy background and he has been made as deputy registrar of security. He also belongs to Kamma.
Okay.
And his entire functioning is like a military camp. And that is one of the reasons.
Very interesting.
I have a few different kind of question. May not be required, but just I would.
Please.
As an academic person, I'm just wondering why the Teachers Association, though you.
No, no, no. Just be turned on.
Academic, I have a question that really bothers me. That why the Teachers Association, which is really strong, have not taken up this issue? Because when you attended, and they invited as a teacher's representative, as a chairperson of the Teachers Association, to a proctorial board, and they didn't give you any power whatsoever. And you have given already writing to them, expressing your protest. Now they have just ignored the teachers' view. Why the teachers are not protesting on this?
Yeah, actually when we submitted this report, what we did is that...
Mics are not working, please.
Yeah, no.
So after we submitted our protest letter, we also protested against the punishment, and punishment was revoked first time. And second time punishment was given after a long time, where our term is getting over.
Also,
so
we gave a vacation. During vacation.
During the vacation, and we are almost, our term is over. So, that is how.
There must be some other features. Your term is over, but association remains there.
Yeah, later in January, just briefly I will tell that there was association meeting, especially after this after he committed suicide and other. I want to make one point here that teachers, most of the teachers are very, very conservative and upper caste. And my friend Ratnam gives him professors, I think 99% of Brahmins. And Brahmins, by their nature, and they are not educated, they did not become democratic like that. So, all of them unanimously, even just we want to pass a one resolution that we are morally responsible for whatever has happened. There is a furor, majority of the teachers, students said that we will not allow you to pass this. And then teachers association almost got divided into Dalits teachers particularly, and also some democratic minded teachers, and then all these upper caste, caste fundamentalists.
That resolution was also not passed. Morally responsible.
No, they didn't allow it. So that is a very, very conservative section.
And this, the latest you wrote to the Vice Chancellor is along with you signed by Deepak Srinivas.
Yes.
You are, okay. Now, you know, the next is the Present Teachers Association. President is different.
Yes.
Who is that?
It's a Professor Abari.
Hello.
His name is Professor Abani.
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 And the secretary
is Professor Tirumal.
Go ahead.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Do you have teachers representative in the EC by nomination or by election?
No, sir. We don't have any representation in EC.
As ever, your association, all the students are complaining about caste discrimination at different levels, both academic and non-academic levels. Has your association ever formed any committee or any report as to how to remove this discrimination or how much truth in the discrimination allegation that they have made? Is any report available made by your association?
We didn't write any report on caste discrimination, but when I was the president, as a body, we were trying to ask Vice Chancellor to implement the reports already which were there. For example, on Senthil, on Puliyala Raju, and also Venkatesh, there are reports.
Did you write that later?
Yeah, we submitted that time to implement the those.
Officially, your association never went into this issue. Mm-hmm. Officially, your association
we
never.
We didn't have any report writing, and we thought.
Are any members individually written any articles or any monograph on this issue?
I myself was a member of two committees on Puliyala Raju and Venkatesh. Those reports are just there, they are gathering dust.
I'm going to ask you why this is not working. Hello.
Take this.
Hello. Yeah. I would request you or all other colleagues or the faculty members of the university, maybe the present president or the secretary, to provide with us the actual data as to how many professors, associate professors and assistant professors, how many out of them belong to SCST or OBC, and same with the students, like total number of students, SCST students and the OBC students, PW students, are the basic, you know, data. And how many are on the
regular permanent positions, how many are on ad hoc or a temporary basis, plus the implementation of the roster, reservation and the roster that follows. I would personally expect from you, because you are a responsible person, you are an active person, because these are the ground facts that are required to elaborate further and relate to the larger issue of discrimination along with. And towards the end, maybe I have to add something more, but then first let's finish with this and then I'll elaborate a bit of my TISS. I function as a liaison officer of the ACST for 25 years there, and it's a success story to a great extent. So I would share that with the permission of Vasudha and anybody, sir. But later. And then they also do they maintain the resources in the hostels, other than the admissions, right? Number one. Number two, what are the additional extra activities that are undertaken by the university with reference to the welfare of the students and the staff, administrative staff and the faculty, right? And what are all are available for the ACST OBC at the Central University, and what is being practiced, implemented. All this data, if you, provide to us, would be very useful for us to relate to, basically, record, interpret, and relate to the larger issue, because the things, I think, begin from there. And then, finally, I would make this particular point that the do they have the teachers separate association that of the ACST teachers?
Yeah, now we had.
Now, you didn't have?
Before also.
You had. And who is into that? President, secretary?
Now, convener is Professor Sudhakar.
Is he here?
No, he has not come. Because Aparao, when in 2002, when he was a chief of them, and there was an agitation by the students against privatization of the mess, and also an insult that has been met by one of the wardens here, Professor Ragnam. So because of that, there was a protest by the students, and because of his active intervention, they were rusticated. And then some of us teachers thought that it is also necessary for us not only to support students but also to protect ourselves from any kind of discrimination to have an association. And that's why it started after 2002, and it is now functioning. It is there now still. And that is the association which designed for its administrative positions.
Is it possible to meet someone from?
Yeah, we can.
Till evening, yes. Any time. Can you manage? Can you arrange?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.